الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، الحديث 25 عن أبي ذر رضي الله عنه أن ناسا من أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قالوا للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: يا رسول الله، ذهب أهل الدثور بالأجور يصلون كما نصلي ويصومون كما نصوم ويتصدقون بفضول أموالهم. قال: أوليس قد جعل الله لكم ما تصدقون؟ إن بكل تسبيحة صدقة، وكل تكبيرة صدقة، وكل تحميدة صدقة، وكل تهليلة صدقة، وأمر بمعروف صدقة، ونهي عن منكر صدقة، وفي بضع أحدكم صدقة. قالوا: يا رسول الله، أيأتي أحدنا شهوته ويكون له فيها أجر؟ قال: أرأيتم لو وضعها في حرام أكان عليه وزر؟ فكذلك إذا وضعها في الحلال كان له أجر. رواه مسلم. Hadith number 25 reported by Imam Muslim rahimahullah on the authority of Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, who said that the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to him and said, O Rasulullah, the people better off financially have left with all the ajr. They pray like we pray, they fast like we fast, but they have more money to give to the poor. They're worried coming and mentioning this to Rasulullah. So Rasulullah mentions to them and says, shall I not inform you of other deeds that are considered sadaqah, charity? Inna bi kulli tasbihatin sadaqah. Every tasbih, subhanallah, remembrance is sadaqah. Kulli takbiratin sadaqah. Every takbir, Allahu Akbar, is sadaqah. Wa kulli tahmidatin sadaqah. Every alhamdulillah is a sadaqah. وكل تحليلة صدقة. Every لا إله إلا الله is a صدقة. وأمر بمعروف صدقة. Enjoining good is صدقة. ونهي عن منكر, forbidding evil, is صدقة. وفي بضع أحدكم صدقة. Relations with your spouse is considered صدقة. So the companions, being astonished, they ask, يا رسول الله, do we fulfill our desires and we still get charity? Sadaqah. That's considered sadaqah. So the Rasul, the Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, says, do you not see that if a person were to fulfill his desires in a haram way, wouldn't that be a sin? Wouldn't he be sinful? So similarly, if he fulfills his desires the halal way, then for him is ajr and sadaqah. And alhamdulillah, in this hadith, Rasulullah ﷺ has given us hope when we see doers of good that are financially better off helping other people. Because not only with helping financially do you gain reward and sadaqat, but simple remembrance, takbir and tahmeed and tahleel, that we ought to do anyways, every single morning and evening. If we don't, we should make a start. About 23, 24 du'as after Fajr, remembrance of the morning, Adhkar al-Sabah, and remembrance of the evening, Adhkar al-Masa, after Asr, all the way to Maghrib, and even after Maghrib is possible. So in these du'as, you have many ad'iyah, many du'as, supplications, and Adhkar, all considered sadaqat and charity, reward and ajr. And there are other ways, and a Muslim should be clever. The same way, when you get your wage, when you get your salary, you count that money, you start flicking it in that envelope, counting, or you go to open your account online banking just to see that alhamdulillah the amount is there. Similarly, you should be conscious of sadaqat and ajr and reward, making the right side of the scales heavy on the Day of Judgment. Because that will grant you access to Jannat. Jannat al-Firdaus. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to be admitted into His Jannat.
Amen.
So be clever with the sadaqat. Every righteous deed is considered a sadaqah, not only these mentioned in the hadith. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, 30 sadaqat, reward. Smiling towards your brother, it's charity. Towards your parents, even more, tenfold. Removing an obstacle from the road is sadaqah. Being good to your neighbor is sadaqah, major one as well. Being good to your parents. Being good at work. Smiling, speaking gently to people, having an upright character. All these are righteous deeds that would earn you more and more sadaqat and reward. And not only this, these are righteous deeds that we know of. That, alhamdulillah, anyone hearing about this would know that, yeah, these are righteous deeds. If I do them, then I'll get more and more rewards. But apart from this, we have to be clever with our niyyah, with our intention. And through manipulating our intention, we can get even more reward and surpass other people who may not think in this way. And this is following the footsteps of the ulama. As mentioned, that the ulama, their business, their tijara, business, profit, is in the intentions. How? You do the deeds that you do a normal day. You sleep, you eat, you go to the gym, you go to the work, you're at home, you're with family, you're with kids. You do the things you normally do. And every one of us, we do to an extent. But by changing your intention, you can get reward for each and every one of those actions. Instead of it just being vain actions that you do on a daily basis. If you, for example, sleep, with the intention, you just make it, you don't even need to say anything. Just need to think in your heart, your intention is, I want to sleep, so I want to sleep early. I want to sleep so I can worship Allah better. You sleep, the whole sleep is ibadah, worship for you. You go to work with intention, I want to go to work to provide for my family, because Rasulullah says, خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ. The best of you are the best to the family. I want to provide for my family. I want to give my wife, my children, my parents, my relatives, everything they want. Your whole time at work, you're sitting behind that desk or any other type of work, you're getting ajr. You go to the gym, you think, I'm going to go to the gym because I want to be healthy and strong to worship Allah better. You get ajr. You're nice towards your family. And as we mentioned this hadith, the best of us are the best to their families. So you are good towards your family with that intention and you get reward. You go out with your friends. You go out to have a meal. You say, I want to meet these brothers for the sake of Allah because I love them for the sake of Allah. I want to meet them and maybe learn from them. That whole time you're sitting there having that massive platter with any type of kebab that's there, and you're getting more and more ajr. So in conclusion, a Muslim not only has got to surpass, of course, in righteous deeds, but at the same time should be clever manipulating the intention to make even more rewards, to gain more rewards, and come closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. And when you deal with intentions and righteous deeds in this way, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeing your efforts, will put more opportunities in front of you. Suddenly you get a call, your relative needs help. Alhamdulillah, you're able to help them. Suddenly you need help, your friend's car broke down, and you go and help. And the more opportunities then after that you take, the more are thrown in your way by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because He knows you want to take them. But if you don't, if you can do it, but you just can't be bothered doing it, and you decline these opportunities, then they will be taken from you, and you won't be given these opportunities. They will be given to someone else, who's more clever than you, with the righteous deeds and intentions, always striving to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to do righteous deeds, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make firm our hearts upon the haqq, upon the deen, upon steadfastness and obedience to Him only, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from strong believers and clever believers, so that we can use righteous deeds, intentions, opportunities to always strive day by day to get closer and closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until we eventually meet Him. بارك الله فيكم وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.
غرباء